An Arizona couple is hiking and biking across the country to support the Citizenship Counts nonprofit. Along the way, John and Diane Eckstein are stopping at schools to teach kids what it means to be a good American citizen. Here with more about the journey is Alysa Ullman, Executive Director of Citizenship Counts, I should say. Should get that right because it really does count. Talk about your organization and what you're trying to do here.
We are a national nonprofit organization that's headquartered here in Phoenix, and we work with middle and high school students. Essentially, we educate them on their rights and responsibilities as citizens of this country and teach them to appreciate and celebrate diversity in the classroom, in the community, and beyond throughout the country. And so we have a series of lesson plans that are integrated into the classroom that teach students about their rights and responsibilities, about the naturalization process, just to kind of help them understand what people who weren't fortunate to have been born here, many people from all over the world come here for these freedoms that some of us sometimes take for granted.
Indeed, how many schools taking part in this?
We've worked...
Public schools, private schools, charter schools?
All of the above, public, private, and charter schools. We spent the first couple years really piloting our program with schools here in Arizona. And as I said, you know, last year we worked with schools in Buffalo, Cincinnati, Washington, D.C., Omaha. So it's, you know, wonderful to this, you know, one of the goals of this journey is to increase outreach and awareness for our program throughout the country.
And I want to get to the journey in a second, but when you describe the curriculum and you describe what your organization does, I keep thinking, what happened to civics classes?
Exactly.
What's going on with them?
Exactly.
Are they not there anymore?
They are there, but I think unfortunately social studies so many times kind of gets pushed to the side because they're not subjects you know, that are tested on. And so, you know, the wonderful thing is, you know, all of our lesson plans are aligned to the National Council of Social Studies standards, and so they're materials and things that really need to and have to be taught in the classroom. And so we've been fortunate that a lot of teachers have, you know, chosen to use our materials because what we really try to do is kind of use these lessons to teach the students about citizenship and then really trying to bring the learning to life. And so in many communities we work closely with the United States Citizenship and Immigration Services and the federal courts for students to be able to host naturalization ceremonies or other celebrations of citizenship in their school or in a community venue.
Boy, hosting those ceremonies, that must be something, huh?
Yeah, it's one of those things that's really hard to describe the emotion of those ceremonies until you go to one. The first time I went to one, I just remember there was, you know, a man there, it was a 9:30 in the morning, and you know, people, you know, from all over the world, you know, waiting to be naturalized, and a man was there in a tuxedo, and he said this was the proudest day of his life, with tears streaming down his cheeks. And so we're just trying to kind of instill that pride in America with these students.
That's great stuff. All right, and we're seeing people here now, you know, going through the process. The kids have to be affected by that. What in the world are these people doing riding their bikes from San Diego to New York? What's that all about?
Exactly. No, well, Diane Eckstein is one of our board members who has just been, you know, so incredible with just ideas and so many ways that she's really helped us advance her, our program. And her husband, Dr. John Eckstein, and her came to me a little over a year ago with an idea they had to really kind of help with visibility and increasing outreach, and that was they wanted to take about 5 months to do a walk and bike across the country, along the way partnering with various schools and community groups that would use our lesson plans that would culminate in naturalization ceremonies or other celebrations of citizenship along the way. It's, you know, as you can imagine, an incredible undertaking. But just the fact that, you know, here you have this prominent physician, Don Eckstein is a physician here locally in the Valley, that would give, you know, 5 months of their time and their lives and their effort and money to do this, really to kind of help advance our cause. And really the inspiration behind their journey is the life of Gerda Weissman Klein, who's our founder, a Holocaust survivor, author, and proud naturalized citizen herself, and the work of our organization. And, you know, as I said, along the way, we started in San Diego, and we worked with a number of schools and groups along the way, went south, went through Arizona. We actually had a couple of events here, one in Phoenix, and then our Tucson event actually coincided with the centennials, one of the official centennial celebrations that was wonderful. And then from there, we went through New Mexico to Las Cruces, Austin, College Station, Dallas, and right now they are right outside of Memphis. So they're about, I think, 2,300 miles through their journey.
And when you say they, that's the couple and the dog.
Exactly.
The dog is keeping a blog, correct?
The dog is keeping a blog, exactly. So yes, John and Diane have a dog, Kip, that is accompanying them on this journey. We also have two incredible interns, Kelly Winter and Tyler Reber, who are with them, and they have just been so amazing in terms of helping with a lot of the logistics along the way. So essentially, John and Tyler are 3,500 miles is what this journey is from start to finish. That's actually 10 times the 350-mile death march that Gerda Weissman-Klein did towards the end of the Holocaust.
I wanted to mention more about Gerda Weissman-Klein because her story is shown at the U.S. Holocaust Museum in Washington, and that was the inspiration there. If she can do it, we can certainly ride our bikes across the country was kind of the thought there, wasn't
it? Exactly, and that's what John said. He said, thinking back to what, she went through, during that, death march, sleeping outside in the winter and terrible conditions. And he said, every night he has his wife to go home to and sleeping comfortably, they're in an RV and whatnot, and, has a meal that to look forward to. And so, basically he's biking 50 miles one day, and then the next day they'll do like a 10, 15-mile walk along with Kip. And then bike the next day and then take the next day off. And it's been absolutely incredible to see. I actually attended several of the events along the way, and just, obviously going to the naturalization ceremonies are extremely inspiring. Each one is unique in its own way, but just seeing his dedication to get on that bike or, take that walk every day, it's incredible.
Well, it's great work there, especially teaching kids about the rights and responsibilities of being a citizen. I'm sure it's a challenge to get those minds around that sort of thing, but it sounds like you're doing a great job. Good luck to the bikers and hikers
out
there.
Thank you.
And good luck to you. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.